Hello students, let's start equivalent fractions. What is equivalent fraction? Now see, this figure, can you observe this figure? See, in first figure, it is divided into two equal parts. This figure is divided into two equal parts and from that one part is shaded. Okay? Same this figure is here, but this figure is divided into four equal parts. This second figure is divided into four equal parts and from four parts, two parts are shaded. From four parts, two parts are shaded. Okay, means from four, two parts means half of the part is shaded, means same like first figure. Okay, means same like first. See, this is half only. Two equal parts, from that one part is shaded, means this we got half. Same like that, this figure also same it is. It has made four equal parts and from four parts, two parts are shaded. Means again it is half, half part is shaded. Okay, now in third figure, if you will observe in third figure, figure is same. Okay, and now see in this, this figure is divided into six equal parts. This figure is divided into six equal parts. See, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Six equal parts are there. Okay, so from six equal parts, three parts are shaded, means half of the part is shaded. Means these all the fractions are equivalent fraction. If you will observe properly, this part is shaded from each figure. What it has done only, what it has done, they have made the parts differently. See, here it has, figure is divided in two equal parts, here figure is divided into four equal parts and here figure is divided into six equal parts, but the shaded part is same. Okay, see, in from two equal parts, this one part is shaded, means half part is shaded. See, from this four equal parts, two parts are shaded. From four, two parts, means half part is shaded and from this six equal parts, three parts are shaded. Okay, means half part is shaded. See, if you will observe, this much part is shaded in each figure. Yes, means these all are equivalent fractions. Okay, so these all are equivalent fraction. If you will do the reduced term, you are going to get the same answer. See here, 2 upon 4. 2 1s are 2, 2 2s are 4. Again, you got half. 3 upon 6. 3 1s are 3, 3 2s are 6. Again, you got half. Means these all the fractions are equivalent fractions. So, let's learn finding equivalent fraction. Finding equivalent fraction. See now this, for example, 1 upon 2. We have to find the equivalent fraction for the given fraction. So, what we have to do for to find the equivalent fraction? For numerator and denominator, we have to multiply with same non-zero number. What I said, to get equivalent fraction, we have to multiply for numerator and denominator with same non-zero number. See now, given fraction is 1 upon 2 and we have to multiply for numerator and denominator with same non-zero number. Means here, we should not multiply by 0. Okay, non-zero number means except 0, any another number we have to write. Okay, so 1 into 2, suppose for numerator also I multiplied by 2, for denominator also I will multiply by 2. Okay, so what I will get? 2 1s are 2, 2 2s are 4. So I got equivalent fraction for 1 upon 2, 2 upon 4. Still many equivalent fractions we can find. See, what is the given fraction? 1 upon 2. 1 upon 2 is given fraction. Now we multiplied. Here we multiplied by 2 for, multiplied for this given fraction by 2 for numerator and denominator. Now we, here we will multiply by 3 for numerator and denominator. See here, 3 1s are 3, 3 2s are 6. Okay, same way, 1 upon 2 is given fraction. So to get equivalent fraction, what we have to do? Multiply for numerator and denominator by same non-zero number. Okay, so multiple. Now here we multiplied 3 by 3. Here we will multiply by 4. Okay, 4 ones are 4. 4 twos are 8. Okay, see one more fraction we will find. 1 upon 2. For numerator and denominator, we have to multiply with same number. So we will get the equivalent fraction. So 5. 5. So 5 ones are 5. 5 twos are 10. So which are the equivalent fractions? See, 1 upon, see which are the equivalent fractions? 1 upon 2, 2 upon 4, 3 upon 6, 4 upon 8, and 5 upon 10. These are the equivalent fractions for the given fractions. Still you can find the many equivalent fractions. See, you can take any another number. It is not like that I have given this. So you have to multiply with the same number. See, suppose if you will take 1 upon 2. Given fraction is 1 upon 2. So, multiple by 7 for denominator and numerator. Mean with, yes, same with numerator and denominator. So 7 ones are 7, 7 twos are 14. So this is also equivalent fraction for the given fraction. Okay, so you can find the equivalent fractions for the given fractions. Okay, let's learn an important property of equivalent fractions. Okay, see, let A upon B and C upon D be two equivalent fractions. What it is given? These are the two equivalent fractions. Okay. So now what we can do? A into D. A multiple by D is equal to, equivalent fractions they have given, is equal to C multiple by B or B multiple by C. Okay. These both are equivalent. It is given. Let A upon B and C upon D be two equivalent fractions. So what we have to do? This numerator and these numbers denominator, we have to do the product of this number, and numerator of this number and denominator of this number, we have to do the product. So this property can be used to find given fraction is equivalent or not. This property can be used. Where this property can be used, the given fractions are equivalent or not.